If you choose a slower diagnostic or a suboptimal breadth of diagnostics for your patient, then actually that patient is going to spend longer in their journey through your healthcare organization, perhaps prolong their length of stay, thereby increasing your overall costs as a healthcare provider for that individual. So diagnostics benefit the stewardship response at two different levels, I guess. Let's focus at the level of the patient first of all. So as long as you purpose your diagnostic appropriately so that it is testing for the right spectrum of potential causative pathogens, and it not only tells you which pathogen is causing your patient their problem, but also starts to then tell you which antimicrobial might be useful for that patient, then you can really optimize your care pathway for that person in front of you in their time of need. So the real-time consequences of not investing appropriately for adequate diagnostics really impact the patient in front of you, meaning that you are going to have to empirically choose the likely best antimicrobial for that patient, which may or may not improve their acute infection. And you may have to cycle through several different courses of antimicrobials before improving their outcome. But separate to that, there's the more meta level at which diagnostics help our stewardship objectives. And that's to provide us with really granular detail around which bugs are causing which problems at the population level for different patient cohorts, so that that can then feed forward and inform empiric antimicrobial use for the next patient with a similar condition who pops along to clinic. If you don't achieve the right spectrum of diagnostics to help patients at the population level, you're really not going to be able to advance your knowledge and understanding of which infections are causing problems in those patients. And therefore, you're not going to be able to advance your service and help patients in the future as you move forward. That if your diagnostic identifies patients with multidrug-resistant organisms early, then perhaps you can appropriately put in place infection prevention and control interventions, which mean that you can isolate that patient safely, stop onward progression of that multidrug-resistant organism to other patients in your organization, and therefore minimize, in turn, the need for them to have antimicrobials. Convincing stakeholders to invest in antimicrobial stewardship endeavors and optimizing our diagnostics to help with this stewardship really is a team sport. So we as infection specialists can often bring a menu of different diagnostic tests to stakeholders and say these are the choices available to us all, but it really requires stakeholders from the clinical forums, from patient forums, from finance to come together and really decide what the purpose of your stewardship interventions and your diagnostics are. And that might seem obvious at first pass, but actually, it's not just around improving a patient's speed to diagnosis and improving a patient's ultimate outcome. Of course, that's central, but actually, it's about doing that in a cost-effective manner. And building better business cases is exactly around that, ensuring you have the right stakeholders around the table, ensuring you have a oneness of purpose about the intervention or the diagnostic you're trying to achieve, ensuring that the costs, benefits, and risks of the intervention you're proposing have been well thought through.